Welcome to my video comparing prokaryotes and eukaryotes. You can find these notes, a diagram, practice questions, and the type notes over at sciencewithsusanna.com. So the purpose of this video is for microbiology students that find themselves taking a microbiology class and being assumed that they know the difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So I just want to do a refresher on that topic for you. So I'm going to start by going through four structures that are found in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And the first of those is a cell membrane, which I will outline in yellow. This bottom picture is meant to represent a bacterial cell, also known as a prokaryote, and the top picture will represent a eukaryote. These are not drawn to scale, meaning that in real life, eukaryotes are like 10 to 100 times bigger than a bacterial cell. So the first thing we're going to write is using a black pen over here is cell membrane. Now, both eukaryotes and prokaryotes will always have a cell membrane. Indeed, anything that is considered alive has a cell membrane, and the role is to regulate entry and exit. In prokaryotes, the cell membrane has the electron transport chain. If they are able to do oxidative phosphorylation, that's that last part of cellular respiration. As opposed to in eukaryotes, they have a mitochondria that has an electron transport chain. I'm going to put that in pink up here. So eukaryotes, they have a membrane-bound organelle called a mitochondria. And we'll put this in pink. So it makes ATP and it does that with something called oxidative, meaning it uses oxygen, and phosphorylation, which means that it adds phosphates to ADP to make ATP. So that's mitochondria, only found in eukaryotes. But again, I want to emphasize prokaryotes can make, prokaryotes certainly can make ATP. They can make it through glycolysis in their cytoplasm, and they can also make it in their cell membrane. They have these proteins in here that are part of their electron transport chain. Not all bacteria are going to have that, but a lot of them will. Okay, so then the second structure that is the same in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes is that they both have ribosomes. So we'll put that in purple, ribosomes, and I'll draw an arrow. Here's one, and then sometimes they're free in the cytoplasm in eukaryotes, and then we'll draw an arrow to one. So they're these little dots. And let's go ahead and take our purple highlighter and boom, 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 boom. Ribosomes are found in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And their job, you may remember, is to translate mRNA into protein. So we call that protein synthesis. Or it's the site of translation. And I think I'll just go ahead and box this. Oh no, I guess you'll still, hopefully you can still see that. So ribosomes perform protein synthesis and they are found in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, next up is cytoskeleton. So take a blue highlighter and both prokaryotes and eukaryotes have proteins in their cells that help to give them shape and support, and also are important in transporting things around the cell. Oh, and so Now, the proteins themselves are not identical to each other, but they serve the same job, and so we still call them cytoskeletal elements. You've probably heard of actin and myosin, and prokaryotes have something very similar to actin, not so much like myosin. Okay, so use your blue pen and write cytoskeleton. That's the third item that we can say is in both of these. So there it's like actin and myosin in eukaryotes, and in prokaryotes they also have things that are sort of like actin. So that symbol means sort of because it's not an identical protein. To back up for just a second, I also want to say about ribosomes, maybe with your purple pen, is that they are different. And the reason that comes into play is because if you take an antibiotic that inhibits the ribosomal activity in a bacterial cell, it will not inhibit to the same extent the ribosome activity in your cells. If it were to do them equally, then the antibiotic would, all it would do is make you sick too. Now, as it is, there is some what we call spillover effect, and so actually there can be at high concentrations an effect on our ribosomes as well. And that could be a side effect of an antibiotic that works to inhibit protein synthesis. Okay, the last shared structure that they have is, I guess I didn't put on here the job. So this gives shape, structure, and transport, depending on the type of cytoskeletal element. And we did this one in blue, cytoskeletal elements. Okay, then last in green, I'd like you to write DNA. In bacteria, make a big loop right here and make an arrow to this, and then an arrow to these cute little guys right here, and then I'll explain what they do. And then up here, you can make your green arrow go to these chromosomes in here. Get your green highlighter and highlight the DNA. So in a eukaryotic cell, see how there's multiple chromosomes and they're linear, they're like in a line. Whereas in bacteria, in prokaryotes, they have one circular DNA chromosome, it's their main chromosome. And then most bacteria, at least I think most, will also have a couple of smaller circles of DNA called plasmids. So let's put this over here. So the DNA of a prokaryote will be a one main circular chromosome, as opposed to in a eukaryote, they're going to have multiple, like we have 46, for example, linear, that means they're in a line instead of in a circle, chromosomes. Nonetheless, it's still all DNA, and DNA is meant to be transcribed, and so DNA gets transcribed to mRNA. I'm running out of room here. Transcribed to mRNA, and then the mRNA will go into the cytoplasm, and on the ribosomes, it will be translated into protein that get the do the work of the cell, basically. So then the DNA of prokaryotes also has, may have some small plasmids. And these might only have a few genes. But those genes might be critical in providing antibiotic resistance. Am I running out of room here at the bottom? There we go. Antibiotic resistance. And what I mean by that is that these little plasmids can actually go through structures in the cell. These are called, this would be a pilus. kind of like, and plural would be pili, and these plasmids can go through this tube to another bacterial cell. And if these plasmids have genes on them that confer antibiotic resistance to this bacterial cell, it can share that resistance with an entirely different species of bacteria that might be living near it. And in so doing, an entire population can become resistant to a particular antibiotic. Okay, so these are the only things that are the same for all, shared. So you've got, they've both got cell membranes, they've both got ribosomes, they've both got cytoskeletal elements, they've both got DNA. Now the next thing I'm going to mention is the cell wall. And the cell wall is going to be found in all prokaryotes, but it's not found in all eukaryotes. So we're going to discuss it slightly in a separate spot. So the cell wall, sorry, I don't want to give the impression that it's not continuous, so I'll go ahead and continue it like that. Okay, so that's the cell wall. It's in all prokaryotes. So all bacterial cells have a cell wall, and it's made of a protein sugar substance called peptidoglycan, which I'll devote a whole video later to, it's already published actually, but it's a little farther along in the playlist, to the structure of bacterial cell walls. Okay, now compare that with eukaryotes, and eukaryotes, they don't always have a cell wall. So sometimes they do, and sometimes they don't. The cell wall of eukaryotes is only found in plants and fungus. If it's in plants, it's made of what we call cellulose. If you eat vegetables, then, and fruit actually, any kind of plant, then the cell walls are, cellulose is one of the main components, and that contributes to the fiber in your diet. So that means that animal cells do not have a cell wall, and protists do not have a cell wall. Okay, the next structure that I will highlight is only found in plants, and that would be chloroplasts. So we could put one like right here, and then it has these little stacks of chlorophyll pigment inside of it. So chloroplasts have green pigment, only found in plants. Now, some bacteria are photosynthetic and they might have the pigments inside of them, but they don't have it enclosed in a membrane called a chloroplast. That's one of the big differences, is that prokaryotes lack membrane-bound organelles. So now I'm going to go back to that pink color and show you the other structures that are only found in eukaryotes. So we already talked about the mitochondria. Now let's also point out that eukaryotes have a nuclear envelope, or you can call it a nuclear membrane. And it's another nice layer of membrane to help protect and keep together the DNA. Then outside of that, and usually surrounding the nucleus, is the endoplasmic reticulum, which in eukaryotes serves the job of folding proteins, and some types of ER make lipids. So that's the endoplasmic reticulum. I'm putting all these things that are only in eukaryotes in pink. I guess I put chloroplasts in green, and that's only in eukaryotes though. So mitochondria, nuclear envelope, endoplasmic reticulum, chloroplasts are only in eukaryotes, specifically in plants. And this is going to fold and transport proteins. What's called smooth ER, which doesn't have ribosomes on it, is also important in making lipids. Okay, then you might remember that these stack of pancakes are called the Golgi apparatus, or the Golgi bodies. And these are important in the modification of proteins and then ship them out to their final destination. All right, so this short review was just meant to jog your memory about the difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. As I wrap up, I'll label down here that this thing that we just drew was a prokaryote, and a prokaryote has a cell membrane, it has ribosomes, it has a cytoskeletal elements, it has DNA, and it has a cell wall. The eukaryote has all of those things, sometimes has a cell wall, animals and protists don't, and then also has other membrane-bound organelles like mitochondria, nuclear envelope, endoplasmic reticulum, and Golgi, as well as things like lysosomes, which I did not draw on here. So let's put down here, prokaryotes have no membrane-bound organelles. And then another thing that this video doesn't really show super well is that prokaryotes are much smaller than eukaryotes. Okay, you can go over to sciencewithsusanna.com if you'd like to print out a blank drawing or see the type notes that accompany this page or do some practice questions, and I have answers there too. See you in the next video.